Okay, so you've created a home buyer seminar form. Basic fields of name, address, emails, phone numbers, even the desired price range. And you want to get this information into Realvolve. Once the form is run, it looks something similar to this. We'll fill in the information and then click on Submit. The key in getting the data into Realvolve is setting up a mailbox within Zapier. You can go to http://parser.zapier.com. Log in, and once you're at your login area, you can create a new mailbox. Once you've created a mailbox, it gives you a unique word that you can use for that mailbox address. Use what's there or create your own. The key is using the correct email address in your form once it's submitted to go to the email address that's supplied here in the mailbox for Zapier. The information is sent to Zapier. Highlight the area that you want to import into the database. In this case, we're going to choose the name area and we'll give it a field name, the address, the email, phone number, and price range. Now your form can look however you want it. Creating these basic fields is important to know for whenever you're setting up the app. Once you've highlighted the data, you've got the fields in there, you're ready to go. Click on the Save Address and Template to store this. Anytime an email is sent to the address, the information will be parsed looking for the specific fields as they've been laid out. Now we want to create a new app. Click on Make a New App. We'll choose our trigger as Zapier Email Parser. New Email. The action will be Realvolve, create contact, and then we'll click on continue. We want to choose the Zapier email account, and then click on continue. Make sure you choose your Realvolve account. Now we need to make sure that we're using the correct mailbox for the email parser. Click on the down arrow and choose the correct email account, then click on continue. At this point, we just need to fill in the fields that we created within the email parser. Click on insert fields. You can see the field names are prefixed with the words parse output and then the field name that you supplied, in this case, full name. We will select the parse output price range as a tag. Select the contact source if desired. Any additional information that you collect within the form that we don't have specific fields for can be created within a note. In this case, I've chosen to put in the plain text of the email into the note so that I have full reference of all the information that was collected. We'll click on continue and then test the parser. Click on test the zap. Once it comes back successful, click on continue. Give the zap a name, then click on turn zap on. Once you go back into Realvolve, you'll see that the information is automatically added into the contact information. Any new email information that comes into that email address will be automatically filled in into Realvolve. If you have additional questions, visit our website or send us an email, support@realvolve.com.